that sky. So, if you remember last time, we did a little bit of exploration on this planet here. Now, you might see loads of little landmarks on my kind of HUD here. That's because a funny thing happened when I stopped recording last time. You may notice, like in the last bits of the video, there was that beacon, kind of waypoint thing. And I thought, okay, I'll just go do this off camera, and I'm sure not much will come of it. Well, a couple of things came of it. Number one, I got a new multi-tool, as you can see here. It's quite fancy. It's basically better than the other one I got. It's got like about four more slots on it, which is really useful. And ooh, hello. And I got a new ship. Yay. Basically, that beacon led me to a advanced life form who was selling the multi-tool. So I bought it. And then in his little complex was a distress signal for a crash ship, and I went to it. And I absolutely fell in love with this ship. I think it looks amazing. It is slightly better than my previous one by like one slot, so not by a huge amount. And but I just really like the look of it. It reminds me very much of Battlestar Galactica, the original TV series, if you ever watched that. I used to love watching that as a kid. Although I will say, I watched the repeats, not the original. Not quite that old. But yeah, I think it looks amazing. I really like the ship. I really like the kind of front end, and the little fan on it as well. Although, quite what use that would have in space, I don't really know, as there's no air. But yeah, so, I mean, the kind of good thing is that we're definitely ready to take off. We're definitely ready to go into space, which is what we're going to be doing. I came to one last little place here. I'm not going to these ruins because most of them are underwater and it's a bit of a hassle. And I really, really like this planet. I really do. It's probably the favourite one I visited. But I'm done with it. Hey there. Yeah, there are things to explore left. You see, I've still got question marks nearby, but I'm not gonna do it. We're getting in the ship and we're taking off and we're going into space. Oh yes we are. And here we are in space. And the planet does look really nice from here. Now then, we wanted to ships over there. We want to probably go to, I guess, this one. Let's activate our pulse engine. I really love the cockpit in the ship as well, because you get a really good, like, all-round view in it, a lot more than you did in my last one or the original ships I had. And yeah, it looks pretty cool. I don't know exactly how the ships work in respect to the different races, but for what I've seen there's, so far, there's three different cockpit designs, or like ship kind of designs, which I imagine are based around three different races. So we had the kind of slightly angular one last time. The original ship we had was quite rectangular, and this is kind of like a curved one. I like this one a lot, actually. It's pretty nice. So here we are coming up on what looks like a pretty purple planet, actually. We've just disengaged. Oh, wow, okay. This looks interesting. Very different to the last one. Quite almost looks volcanic, doesn't it? Certainly looks rocky. space is, has a tendency to... Okay, so it's got some things. Oh, there's somewhere to land over here. There's a little base. Let's land here. Set foot on this new planet. Let's see whether or not it's going to kill us. Contaminated planet. Volatile winds, low sentinels, copious flora, but empty fauna. Okay. Oh, okay, it's radioactive. Interesting. I think these. They're pretty cool. Can't seem to analyze them, though. Let's get our save point on. Oh, wow. Okay. I love this, coming to new worlds. I've probably only been to like 5 or 6, if that. That looks like emerald. Okay. Let's have a little pop in here and see what's going on. What the hell is that thing? That looks quite deadly. So I wonder if, because it's quite radioactive, if it, that does not look good. It does not look good at all. I don't like the look of that thing. I glimpsed the crimson orb between the clouds. A vast and baleful eye, unblinking and monstrous. Fear turned the blood in my veins to ice. I was gone. So afraid it would see me, but then the clouds moved and it was gone. I was no longer certain if it had ever been real. Perhaps the fungal deposits from the last world I visited are still clogging my exosuit vents, affecting my cognition somehow. I clean my filters 6 times now, but I still feel it inside me. So blatantly is, isn't it? I mean, that really blatantly is. There's not really much over there I want anyway, so. Okay, so, wow. Interesting planet. Our ship's landed quite nicely there. I believe this is Emerald, yeah. Now, this is worth quite a lot, so I'll mine it up. You may notice my mining beam is incredibly quick. Yeah, it's got a few upgrades on it. Especially when you consider kind of how it was to begin with. It would take me ages to mine things when I first started in the game, but now, not so bad. We'll pick some of this up because it sells for quite a lot of money. And that's pretty useful. Now I do actually have a bit more cash than when I left off last time, because I uploaded all my data, which gets you money. So I'm doing okay at the minute. We'll take the plutonium, which you never know. What's this? Aluminium. I'll take it. It might be useful. There are a few like minerals and things that we need that we didn't get on the last planet. Look at these things. I haven't seen any animals yet. Do wonder if there'll be any. Discovered something here. said that though, we do have to keep an eye on our radiation levels. I'm thinking that's iridium, yeah. Okay. I've got plenty of iridium. Go back this way. And you know, I've said before, I'm in no hurry to, you know, rush around and be the first person to do this or be the first person to do that. I'm just enjoying taking my time with the game. And in actual fact, despite being a big fan of the first game, I haven't yet purchased the Deus Ex, new Deus Ex game, because I've just been enjoying No Man's Sky so much that I'm like, well, I probably wouldn't play it that much. I'd probably want to jump back into No Man's Sky and play that. So there's a sentinel. So yeah, I've kind of held off purchasing it until I'm kind of ready to play, if that makes sense, which is quite strange for me. Usually I'm a sort of person who kind of be a bit like, you know, I'm a bit magpie-ish, I see something shiny, and I just have to get it, you know. I'm like, oh, this game looks great, you know, I want to play it, but I've just been enjoying No Man's Sky. I totally understand why some people don't like it. Might feel it's dull, might feel like it doesn't live up to what they wanted, but for me, you can't beat it for just a kind of relaxing, like, ambient, atmospheric kind of game. And this kind of sense of discovery is fascinating. See a film or something like that, and you were just like, oh, I really wish I could just go off and explore that. I really wish I could go and look at that point in the distance and be like, I want to go there. And this game lets you do that, which is incredible, really. We're getting into an era where technology is getting to the point whereby our kind of dreams when we were younger, or in particular my dreams when I was younger, are beginning to be realised. I started out playing video games when I was pretty young, actually maybe 5 or 6, and they were, you know, what would be considered very basic games, and as I grew up, the games obviously evolved and changed, but probably in the last sort of 5 years or so, maybe 10, has seen the kind of greatest changes, I think, because the industry in itself has become so much more. It's become massive now. You know, it's a multi-billion-dollar industry, whereas it used to be the kind of video games used to be the kind of thing people would kind of laugh at you for playing, you know. A massive geek with your sort of Commodore 64 or, you know, things like that. such a small studio with, you know, a handful of people can make a game like this, then you know, it's exciting to think what, you know, the big developers are bringing. You know, one of the games I'm very excited for is Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm a massive, huge fan of the Mass Effect games. Played through them all multiple times. The only one I haven't played multiple times is Mass Effect 3, simply because I find it difficult because that game is the end, if that makes sense. It's the end of that series. And it's difficult to see how much of that. Okay, oh, we actually got a dynamic resonator. I can repair my hyperdrive. No, I can't. I didn't do it. Why have I got a dynamic resonator then? Okay, well, that's weird. I actually need to make some warp cells. I'll do that next episode, probably. We won't leave this system, no. We won't warp to the next one until I have explored it a bit more. But yeah, I was saying, with Mass Effect 3, I find it difficult to play that one because I loved the crash ship. I did wonder whether or not they existed without beacons. Interesting. I found, it may sound really weird, I just kind of found that really emotional. Mass Effect 3, it was a combination of, you know, some of my favourite video games ever, and the ending is, whatever you think of it, very emotional. And I'd find it difficult to play through again. Am I going to get another ship, really? I don't think I am, actually. I quite like the look of this ship. It's very sort of cargo-esque, isn't it? It's actually pretty cool. That's got 15, mine's got 16, so we keep the ship we've got. I actually really like that one, though. That's a nice-looking ship, in a weird way. You know, it's like a... it's very angular and square, but it's pretty cool. Judging by the destruction within, this ship must have crash-landed with particular ferocity. Cargo thrown from its containers is strewn everywhere. It's hard to distinguish between what are remnants of the pilot's metallic shell and which pieces of debris are from the ship itself. The black box has survived intact, but it makes a strange fizzing noise as I approach. Boost black box signal. The box part is burning my arm. I make the ship easily discoverable by the electronic race. Okay. Well, I injured myself, but well, how interesting. So I guess that answers a question I had then, which was do those crash ships just exist? And they do. Now, one of the things I kind of found out, really, not through playing myself, but through watching some other playthroughs, but I haven't spoiled anything. I'm watching them quite sparingly, but one of the things I found out was that, in terms of your ship, if you are attacked and destroyed, say by pirates in space, you lose your ship. So that would pretty much explain why these sort of crashed ships are, well, there's so many of them, because the chances are at some point you're probably going to lose. Oh wow, that's a big place over there, isn't it? At some point you're probably going to lose everything you've got. But if it, I don't mean everything, but certainly the ship you've got and stuff like that, so it's definitely worth bearing that in mind. But as you can see, it's not too difficult to come across new ships. I guess the only downside is that you can never really guarantee just an exosuit upgrade, we don't need that. You can never guarantee what ship you're going to get. So, you could get a really good one and then kind of lose it straight away. Or you could get, could be stuck with keep finding, kind of low level ones, I guess. Okay, found the word for pass. So going back to Mass Effect, I don't know, maybe you have played it, maybe you haven't, maybe you liked it, maybe you didn't, but one of the things that game does so well is its characters, very memorable, and a lot of them stay with you through all three games, and, especially your main character, whoever your shepherd is, and, Mass Effect 3, I guess I was quite lucky because a lot of people complained about the ending not kind of feeling right or not having enough kind of closure in it, as it were, and they did they kind of patched it later on, added some stuff into it and it was a lot better, and I didn't play it for a little bit when it came out, so that's the only one I experienced, and I thought it was brilliant. Hello. I love their reactions when you walk in. Engineer entity. I've got my inventory's full, okay, what can I transfer to my ship? Okay, I've got a space over there, so let's, I'm going to transfer the emerald. Hello. Okay, I can't understand a word he's saying. The electronic life form is processing a signal that emanates from a distant location deep. Space, endless processing units are combining to crack the code of a strange mathematical language. Rare elements are being pulled from the resource vaults at its feet, but some are running low. I feel bright lights constricting and directing their attention onto me. Oh, okay. So, we probably want to give him something. Let's give him some oxide. The oxide fuel, the code cracking procedure, a faint orb glows red on the screen and slowly fades. Oh, that's cool. That's nice, thank you, sir. It's very kind of you. Just gonna go over here and take that. Just got a micro density fiber as well. Not really sure I wanted that one, but oh, this is a thing here as well. The observatory sterile functional layout suggests its form overseer could have been electronic in origin, judging by the decades old beacon flashing on screen. The entity left this place long ago. Perhaps if I can decipher the code, I can learn where the beacon originated. 2916. Success. I learn of a new location in the cosmos. There's a couple of places around here already, isn't there? Okay, so there's a ruin over there. That's fine. Let's say goodbye to the gentleman here, thank you very much, sir, for your custom. And be on our well, hang on. Why do I get the feeling that that's not the only thing here? Because I think it is actually, to be fair. Entrance. One thing I learned earlier actually as well was that when they actually have specific landing like sections, basically land on some of them, it doesn't use fuel from your launch thrusters, which is really cool. So there's definitely something over there. There's definitely something just down there. There's definitely something just down there. Oh my god, there's loads of things everywhere here. There's something over there as well. Don't know if there's any animals on this planet though. There's something there, there's something there. There's something over here. Research station there. Certainly plenty of stuff. Is that emerald again there? We've got the ruin over there. We've got some sort of like, that's like a, you can steal stuff from that. You do alert the sentinels, but an exosuit upgrade, which we do not need. We definitely do not need that. We are full there. That emerald is that emerald, or I'm thinking it is, but I'm just gonna put it down. Is there a little somewhere to explore nearby? Because it seems to be incredibly green. Somewhere up here, there's land here. Check out that stuff, see it is emerald. Obviously just have a little, you know, look in here first though. Research specimen. One thing I don't know actually is what the what your level with the different races gives you, whether it gives you access to things which you wouldn't normally get. What's this stuff? That was pretty freaky. One thing this multi-tool does have is a plasma grenade launcher, so we can fire these. And you can actually you can upgrade it, but it actually does make a physical hole in the ground. And one of the things they showed in a trailer I saw for the game was you could actually make shelter for yourself by using the grenades to actually, like, is that emerald? Yeah, it is emerald. I'll take some of it for sure. Oh, inventory full, because I won't take that much of it. This can get discarded. Yeah, you can actually like blast a hole in a wall to get yourself into a cave. sentinel then. The weird thing is, when I collect emerald, they never seem to attack me. This is certainly a hefty chunk of it. How much are we at? We're at halfway, basically. Procedure generated, or if that's you know, something fairly predetermined within the game. What's down there? Oh, that's the thing I saw, wasn't it? Is it? Yeah, it is. What's this stuff? Get right, okay. Where's my ship? Ship holds 500 at a time. We've got 470, so that's fine. Let's go down to that beacon and I've been lazy, I could have just walked there, you know. Look at this. I'm like literally flying, like I'm not one of those people who lives like a 10-minute walk away from the shops and then gets in their car and goes there. There's a guy in here. Hello. Oh look, he's got a that's a multi-tool upgrade there. Going into the B days. Something data, and there is, I don't know. The electronic life form narrows its mask lights in frustration and furiously taps at its workstation. It looks at me with agitation, presumably doubting that a low intelligence being can help it access the terminal. Past it would certainly help here, but whether the life form would appreciate the illegal device is unknown. I'll just try it myself. Oh, okay. Wow. Okay, fine. Oh god, look at this thing. That looks incredible. Oh dear god, I think that's better than my actual multi-tool. Wow. So my one's got 14 slots, this one's got 16. That means it's better. Okay, I'm taking it. Oh wow, okay. And we've got a terminal here, which is cool. Because we can sell some items. Sell all that emerald and make back all that money we just spent. And sell that shielding plate as well, because that's not useful. Have I got anything in my actual inventory I want to sell? No. Okay, well, thank you, sir. Sorry I couldn't help you out too much, but you've definitely helped me out with that multi-tool. Let's just have a look at it quickly. Ricochet bolt caster. I think my other one had slightly more powerful stuff on it, but I can certainly craft things. Looks a bit of a beast though, doesn't it? Okay, we probably want to go over here. We definitely want to discover this place for a start, so that's fine. There's a ship up there. It's the first ship I've seen on this planet. I don't have the analyzer on it. Let's see if we can make that now. Yeah, the analysis visor. We want the ones which help us, like, mine stuff quicker. What do we need for this? Chrysonite. Quite a lot of it. There's any of that on this planet, but we'll keep an eye on it. If there is, then we will pick it up. Okay. Well, there's a multi-tool tech over here. Let's take this. Okay, yep. That's the one we already knew. The image of the observatory former electronic overseer flickers on the console next to flash of the beacon. How long it waited to receive such a signal from an unknown part of space. Perhaps I could send the reply the overseer never could, but first I must decipher this incredibly difficult code. Well, oh my goodness, how lucky was that? Just joking, of course, because that is such an... there are way too many places to explore on this planet. Oh my god. Okay, it's a ruin. I definitely need to explore more of the ruin. What are you looking at? More of the ruins, because I need to learn more about the need to learn more of the language. Okay, let's... You see, it doesn't use any of my thingy to use that, any of my plutonium in my launch thrusters. No, that's not that interesting, to be honest. Gonna keep heading, I think, towards this thing. I don't need exosuit upgrades, so that's not really good. That's obviously where we just were. Appears to be another one over here. Should we come in here? Yeah, why not? Then we'll make a beeline for that. Advanced life form. Maybe we'll have a bit more luck with him than we did with the other fellow. See what's in here. Okay, we've been to that beacon. Pretty sure of that. Okay, what's in here? Ah, this is the... this stuff, isn't it? And kind of creeps the heck out of me. Oh, can I not use that? Whether or not it's just something in the game or whether or not it's here. species like it, then I hope they're all dead like this one. At first I thought it some tragic remnants of a matter transfer tenka malfunction. A cage of bones and flesh studded with random patterns of crooked teeth and ruminary lidless eyes, but no, some horror of twisted evolution warped by cruel nature. I can't help but picture what it would have looked like alive. I cannot help but fear that it will live again. That's pretty freaky. Some other kind of things around, but I want to head off to this advanced life form before I die of old age. I mean, yeah, let's be fair, we've upgraded very nicely, yeah. I've got a good ship, got a good multi-tool. I need to upgrade it a bit to make sure I'm kind of nice and combat ready, if that ever happens. I haven't not been attacked by pirates yet, or anything like that, which kind of scares me a little bit, but it, oh god, this can take forever to get to this one. God, look at that, that looks beautiful, that banner. I will look forward to going, oh, okay, it changed slightly, it's not quite so beautiful. How to kind of impress. My god, this alien life form is literally the other side of the planet. It's quicker going to another planet than it is going around a planet. Imagine that for a minute. Imagine it being quicker to get to the moon in our real reality than it would be to go from, say, England to Japan. That's pretty crazy. Our multi-tool. That's incredibly lucky actually, because to be honest, I've found a fair few different multi-tool upgrade places, and a lot of the time they give me ones which are slightly worse or the same as the one I currently have. So I do have upgraded by, I don't know how many slots, 4 or 5 I think. It's actually quite impressive, I think. Oh look, there's another ship over there. In fact, there's 2 ships there. Oh god, please don't attack me. A bit scary. That's like, what are they doing exactly? It's probably something I'll do a little bit off camera, is actually kind of prepping, because I have a feeling that I'm getting to the point where, you know, things are going to start happening to me soon. I don't know if it's a random occurrence in the game, or if it's something that happens once you, you know, play after a certain amount of time or whatever, but I have a feeling like to defend myself soon. Okay, I got a proper landing pad here. So this is kind of like the other side of the planet almost. Well, not really almost, it is the other side of the planet. Let's see who's in here, shall we? I just love looking up at planets in the air. Oh my god, he's got a multi-tool upgrade. Kill me now. I've got to have a look at it first. Okay. I think it's the same one as mine. Oh god, it's not. It's better. Oh my god, I cannot believe this. That's a 20 slot. Mine's only an 18. Okay, well. Hey guys, we just upgraded our multi-tool 3 times. In like half an hour. What's up, buddy? Experiment low rare silicate. Okay, so we need some rare silicate. Oh, we need some chrysonite. Okay, let's see if we can buy some. If not, I'll probably come back. These might give us something interesting. Stone. No, we don't. So maybe I'll go have a look for some and then come back. Yeah. But I'll probably do that off camera now. We have massively upgraded our multi-tool. There's only, what, 1, 2, 3, 4 slots that we could possibly upgrade it with. It's a lot bigger than the one we started with, isn't it? That's cool. Very cool. words have we learnt? 100 words. Wow. That's a lot, you know. That is a lot. Go over here and save a link. So we've had an interesting little adventure on this planet. What I might do next episode, I'll probably explore this planet a little bit more off camera. But what I might do is spend a bit more, oh god, didn't mean to do that. I might spend a little bit more time in space, because that's something I haven't really done. Actually kind of flying about, seeing, as I say, I want to kind of prepare my ship a little bit, with some better upgrades and things like that. See exactly what those pirates think they're going to be playing at, and maybe they'll be messing with the wrong guy. Oh god, that's a beacon over there that will lead me to something, or maybe we'll explore this planet. No, no, I don't know. The ship over there, it hasn't got any animals that I've seen. In some ways it makes me feel the same way, a little bit daunted, in the same way The Witcher 3 does when you enter a new area and there's all those question marks all over the map and you just don't know where to start, you know? It's kind of a little bit like that. Okay. We've already analysed that. This. And remember, if you want to have your name on anything, any planets, any creatures, anything that catches your eye, you know, anything can be named, as it were, then just leave a comment and I'll do that. And obviously remember that everything that I upload goes onto the kind of server, as it were, and anybody who happens to explore the same planet or the same system or whatever, we'll see that there. So it's kind of like leaving a little legacy in a way. But we've upgraded our multi-tool somewhat, so thank you so much guys for joining me on this little adventure, this new planet.